In this video, we're going to be taking a look at Chebyshev's theorem. Whoops. And we'll also look at how to create Chebyshev intervals. So Chebyshev's theorem is actually a theorem that helps us describe what percentage of our overall data will fall into different categories. So what the theorem itself actually says is, for any set of data either population or sample, and for any constant k greater than 1, the proportion of the data that must lie within k standard deviations on either side of the mean is at least 1 minus 1 over k squared. For any set of data, either population or sample, and for any constant k that's greater than 1, the proportion of the data that must lie within k standard deviations on either side of the mean is at least 1 minus 1 over k squared. And that's all well and good, but what the heck does that mean, right? So basically, if we picked a number for k, and since k has to be greater than 1, let's say I'm going to go ahead and pick 2. So if I put the number 2 in here, so if I did 1 minus 1 over 2 squared, that's going to be 1 minus 1 fourth. 1 minus 1 fourth is 3 fourths, or 0.75, 75%. And so what that tells me from Chebyshev's theorem is that at least 75% of the data must lie within two standard deviations on either side of the mean. So that would be the mean minus 2 times the standard deviation to the mean plus 2 times the standard deviation. Okay, at least 75% of the data is going to lie within 2 standard deviations on either side of the mean. Okay, it helps us quantify how much of the data we expect to be in that interval. Similarly, if we plugged in the number 3 here for k instead of 2, what we would find is that at least 88.9% of the data must lie within mu minus 3 sigma to mu plus 3 sigma. Okay, 3 standard deviations on either side of the mean. We should have captured at least 88.9% of the data. And if we go out to using the number 4 here for k instead of 3, because this was k equals 2, this is k equals 3. If we were to put in k equals 4, that result from Chebyshev's theorem tells us that at least 93.8% of the data must lie within mu minus 4 sigma to mu plus 4 sigma. Okay, 4 standard deviations on either side of the mean. So this is what we know. Okay, so let's say that I knew that the, let's say the average earned income in Whatcom County. And let's say that's per household. And let's say it's $54,000 a year. And let's say the standard deviation there is, I don't know, $6,000. And so let's say that what I want to do is compute a 75% Chebyshev interval centered around the mean. Okay, so this is what I'm trying to do. I am trying to figure out about the mean, if the mean is in the center of this interval, where should I expect to find 75% of the average earned incomes in Whatcom County? Well, if I go back to my results of Chebyshev's interval, and I see this magic number 75% here, that's this one that I'm looking at. At least 75% of the data must lie within mu minus 2 sigma to mu plus 2 sigma. Okay, so 75% mu minus 2 sigma to mu plus 2 sigma. So here my mu is 54,000 minus 2 times 6,000. That's the lower bound for the interval. 54,000 plus 2 sigma, 2 times 6,000. Okay. So if I take 54,000 and subtract 2 minus 6,000, which of course is 12,000, I am looking at 42,000 on the low end. 2, if I take 54,000 and add 12,000, then I'm looking at 66,000. Okay, so there's the computation piece. Compute a 75% Chebyshev interval centered around the mean. We did that. Now, what is this actually telling us? This is telling us that 75% of the household annual incomes in Whatcom County, because that's what I was measuring, are between 42,000 dollars a year and 66,000 dollars a year. Okay, we can expect that if we were to look at all of the household annual incomes in Whatcom County, 75% of them should be between 42,000 and 60,000, at least 75% of the annual income should be between 42,000 and 66,000. It could be more than that, but at least 75%. It gives us a minimum bound. Now, if we wanted to find 88.9%, we would simply go out 3 standard deviations on either side of the mean. And if we wanted to find 93.8, we'd go out 4 standard deviations on either side. Okay. But this is the idea of how to use Chebyshev's theorem to find a Chebyshev interval about the mean. It just gives us an entire range of values where we can expect to find a certain percentage of the data.